1950s, when the context was so different in Bangladesh, one of the initial criticism I was making against the banking system, that not even 1% of their borrowers happened to be women. So I wanted to make sure when I began that half the borrowers in my program are women. It was such a bold kind of statement. People were shocked. How can you have these women to do anything with money? When I went to the women to talk to them, they said, no, give it to my husband. So women themselves denying the fact that, that this money is available, she can start a business on her own, but she's so afraid even to touch money, saying they give it to my husband. So that's where the process of convincing her began. It's not the husband yet. That process took 6 years of our time to just to convince them that they can handle money. Once they started taking this money, then husband gets into the picture. He feels terribly insulted that how can you give money to my wife without giving it to me? So I should be the one receiving the money. If I want to give it to her, then she will get it. So that became a big hassle and big tension in the family because we want to give the money to women. And the tension became such a worry for us. We didn't want to create tension in the family just because we want to lend money. So we started a serious discussion with the husbands, groups of husbands together, so that they understand what we are doing. It's not against their interest. It is for the family as a whole. It took a lot of time to convince them that it's better to have a two-income family rather than a one-income family. All the burden of the family is in you. So we came up with lots of explanations and things to make it easy for him. And then we didn't stop there. We had a separate meeting with the women, explaining to them what the worries of the husbands are, so that they understand and what the rules of the bank is. Then we have a combined meeting, husbands and wives, so that they can communicate to each other in the same language, because otherwise one will be quoting, oh, bank told us such and such. Why are you telling us this way? So that everybody understands that. That was the beginning. And that started working once we got them into the picture. But the first year is always very difficult. Despite everything that you have convinced, when actually it comes that women started making decisions and doing it, and he gets again very irritated. How come I don't know anything about it? But then he's involved in it for marketing purpose, because women cannot go to the market, so she gives it to the husband to buy things, to sell things. She gets integrated into the system. After you go through the first year, the relationship becomes much more closer. And they start admiring, the husband start admiring the capability of the woman. So it's a long drawn process. Without the husband, if we concentrated on the woman, it would have collapsed right there. Families would be disintegrated, the whole system would collapse. But bringing them in, it becomes very strong. Second year, third year, they become strong partners in the businesses they do. And that's how, in the process, many of the women became more successful businesswomen than the husband himself. And he was talking about the telephones. When we brought the telephone in Bangladesh, Grameen phone, we announced that we want to bring phones in the villages, then give the telephone in the hands of the women. Such a shocking news. You bring it to the village, it's a shocking news, and you give it to women, and a poor woman, extra shocking news. People couldn't believe that this is a crazy thing. How can you do that? But we did that. Women adopted it for income generating activity so that they can sell the service of the... So actually telecommunication came to the villages of Bangladesh through women, because she's the one selling the telephone service in the villages. Today it's everywhere. If we had started with men, probably it wouldn't have spread that way, because this half the population would always be ignored, as if they, who needs a telephone? Within about 2 years' time of the launching our program, 2 to 3 years' time of the launching of the program, we had thousands of telephone ladies in the villages. In the fourth year, we had 400,000 telephone ladies all over Bangladesh selling telephone services. And then people came to them, men, women, they became business for everybody. It's everywhere now. Out of a total population of 150 million people in Bangladesh, there are 65 million subscribers today.